Diane Wood. I'm with Peaceful Vocations in Fort Worth, based in Fort Worth, and we are a counter-military recruitment organization. We have been around for 7 years now. We go into Fort Worth high schools, and we talk to youth about the realities of military life. We provide a counterbalance to the aggressive tactics of the military use to beckon and suck our youth into the military. And when we first started the organization, of course, we're a part of a larger coalition of groups throughout the nation who do this, because the military has a lot of money to spend on getting our youth into the military. And they often deceive the youth and don't give them all the really important facts that they need. So we've been going to high schools now for 7 years, and we set up literature tables. We give classroom presentations. We give presentations at other events, and we give alternative careers, career opportunities. We've worked really hard to develop a local a list of good places where youth can really find some good opportunities, such as union apprenticeships, learn to be a plumber or electrician or a painter or a forklift operator, many things like that, or an artist or a creative writer. We give AmeriCorps information where youth can actually, if they have a high school diploma, they can simply join AmeriCorps, who does community service projects. They stay with AmeriCorps for 12 months, and AmeriCorps pays a room and board, gives them a little spending money, and at the end of 12 months gives them a college stipend for $4,700. So we do those kind of career opportunities. But we got started because we were aware that the military in our schools were doing unbelievable things. They were roaming the halls during school breaks, and calling kids out of class. They were actually being allowed to bring students out of class and talk to them, and putting all kinds of military posters up in the schools. So we have been able, after a lot of battles, we've been able to stop a lot of that and diminish that. It's still there, the military is still there, but we no longer see posters in the schools, for example. But if we would put up our poster, which was very different beside the military poster. So now they've taken down all the military posters. But the school system did not welcome us. It took a long time for us to actually get into the school. We ended up having to go into the back door and talk to individual principals and gradually get into individual schools that way. And then finally had some meetings with the administration. We've had several meetings with the administration.
Fort Worth?
In Fort Worth, yes, in Fort Worth ISD. Our full focus is that we have the right to have equal access to the students. Whenever the military is in a school, whether they're doing a presentation, or having a literature display, or doing a classroom presentation, or whatever they're doing, that the other side has a right to present their side. That's not a law in this particular judicial district, but it is a law. It was a law that was passed 20 something years ago in California, where a group like ours sued the Los Angeles school board because they would not let the counter-military recruitment group put an ad in the newspaper, in the school newspaper. And so they ended up winning that. It's a long story, but the appeals court in that judicial district said, just what I had explained, that you have a right. Now, even though that's not an actual law in this judicial district, many lawsuits have been won on the back of that law, of that lawsuit. So pretty much attorneys and legal people know that has happened. So we had to meet with a school attorney. We just had many issues. We've had JROTC instructors to come up to us and talk about how we're not telling the truth about things. We have very radical literature that talks about how women are raped. One out of three women are raped in the military, which is true. And we've had JROTC instructors tell us that it's not true, but that's actually a Department of Defense statistic. We explain explain to you that they don't have to ever talk to military recruiters if they don't want to. We tell them that the reason they get multiple calls at their home from military recruiters and surprise visits is because there's a law passed in the No Child Left Behind Act that says that any school who receives federal funds must hand over all the students' contact information at the beginning of the year. They have to do that. There is also, by law, a way that parents can opt out, or they can sign a form and say they do not want their child to be contacted by the military. But most parents miss that. That's sent out in the beginning of school form. So one of our educational goals is to inform parents and students that that form exists and to watch for it at the beginning of the year. So they can check if they want, I do not want my child to be contacted by the military. But even if that form is checked, the military goes around it and has another way, because the military, we found out, has been giving the Armed Services Aptitude Battery Test, which is the test that you take when you're going to join the military. But the military uses it also for a recruiting tool. It's even explained in the Department of Defense manual and the JROTC manual that this can be used as a recruiting tool. So they give this 3-hour test during school time to students, which is supposed to measure their aptitudes. And they use it then to, you know, tell students how you did really good in this area and so forth and so on. And they use it to get them to come into the military, and they tell them things like, you know, well, you can do this job or this job or just this job. So they give this test without parents' knowledge and without parents' permission. And on that test, they get all the students' contact information, their social security number, their gender, their race, what their plans are after high school. So they have all this personal information. So it hasn't done any good if they sign the release form stating they did not want to be contacted by the military. So one of our big focuses recently has been to have a letter writing campaign to the department, Texas State Board of Education, to explain to them that it's illegal for students to be taking this test without the parents' knowledge. So we've done a lot of education about that at different events to parents, and we've had parents sign letters so that they can be aware of the problem and also hopefully impact the Texas Board of Education about that. We tell the students that the military is not just a job, it's actually 8 years of their life where they're controlled by the military. Everything they do is controlled 24 hours a day. They do not have a choice. If the military does not want to honor their desire to have a military option of being a computer person or whatever they want to do, the military is not obligated to honor that, and they often don't. And also, kids think that I'm going to be in the Air Force or the National Guard, the Navy, and therefore I'm not going to be in combat. But the facts are that people in those armed services are now in combat, on ground combat. So we give them information like that, and we also give information about the very poor veterans care that people get when they come back from the military, because the facts are, if you're injured, you do not get enough money to live on. And so anyone who's injured and cannot work in the military has to depend on their family to take care of them, because the disability they get is very, very, very small.
Well, if they want to learn more, where can they go to find out more information?
So if you want to learn more, you can go to our website, which is peacefulvocations.org. Or you can email us, peacefulvocations@yahoo.com. We'll be happy to meet with you, talk with you about literature. You can join our group. On our website, there's several documents of literature. There's also some different interviews that we've had. There's a lot of information available. Does that answer your question?
That's it. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much.